I'm pretty sure you've heard the old adage, you can't judge a book by its cover, right? Of course. We always heard that growing up. It's conventional wisdom. But the problem with that saying is, of course you can judge a book by its cover. How else would you know you wanted to buy that book, right? We go to the bookstore, we see a book, and we look at the graphics that are on the front, the illustration, the cover design, the title. We read the blurb on the back. We take a look, is this an author that I've read before? Is this a subject matter that I'm interested in? And then you judge the book by its cover, and then you buy it. People spend tons of money thinking about how the cover is going to look to entice you to buy it. So I was thinking, you know what would be a really cruel joke to play would be like, say you go into the bookstore and you find these hardback books that have the dust jackets, and you find a dust jacket, you find a book that has a similar shape and size to another book in the store, and then you take the cover, you take the dust jacket off this book, and you go and you place it on another book that's not as popular, and then what you'll end up is people will buy the wrong book. They'll go home and they'll think they got a certain book, and then they'll start to read it and then realize maybe, 4 or 5 pages in, hey, this isn't the book I bought. And I almost wonder, like, how long would it take someone to realize that they were reading the wrong book? I mean, obviously, if you got a work of fiction and you traded it with a cookbook, then yeah, right away they'd know. But if you had two works of fiction, maybe even two books that were similar in subject matter, like one crime novel with another, how long would it take them to realize they were reading the wrong book? So, in thinking about that, also asking, does that sometimes happen to us with religion? Does that sometimes happen to us with the Bible? With the Bible, I think we're handed this book and we're told one thing. We're told this is a book about how to go to heaven. This is a book about how to escape the world when you die. And then you get the book and you open it and you read the inside, and the inside doesn't match up with that dust jacket. I mean, you read about Jesus who came and repaired the world. You read about Jesus who healed the sick. And you think, well, if the world was doomed, if we're just so adamant to leave, then why does Jesus take all the time to fix everything? If the world is broken and doomed, then why did Jesus come in the first place? I mean, surely he thought the world was worth saving. He thought the world was worth fixing. And maybe the secret message of Jesus isn't about leaving the world when you die. Maybe it's about fixing the world while we're here. Hey, this Sunday we're still walking through looking at Jesus in 3D. Asking the question that if we were to put on a different set of glasses, if we were to view Jesus in a different way, could we see something new? Could we learn something new? And so this Sunday we're talking about the secret message of Jesus. It's going to be a lot of fun. I hope to see you there.